Today is Sunday, and yeah, it's game guru time. So let me show you what we're making today. I'm gonna walk up to this lady here, and as soon as we get close, you can see that we are displaying in an RPG text box, sort of like Final Fantasy. Now, if you press E, you can skip to the next text, and when she has nothing else to say, the box disappears.
It is dangerous to go alone. Take this.
Oh, wait. I had to do like a girl voice.
It is dangerous to go alone. Take this.
That's my girl voice in a Sunday morning. Wow, so early. Holy mackerel. Has anyone up yet? Okay, guys, this is what we're making today. If you like making your own 3D games, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Yeah, for this video, we're gonna aim for 50 likes. Yeah, so smack that like button and let's continue. Okay, so before we get started, I'm gonna give a shout out to Knightpie. Knightpie makes kenguru tutorials and other stuff, like you can see in his channel. Subscribe to Knightpie, I will leave a link down in the description below. So let's continue. Oh, wait, we have another incoming message. This is a shout out to Bumboy. Yeah, so whoa, that's a lot of gameplays. Yeah, he makes pretty cool stuff too. Yeah, check out his channel.
And don't forget to subscribe to Bumboy.
Okay. Here's the medieval lady, and let's go to her properties. Okay, I'm gonna go to main. Let's pull out her script. Let me see. We'll duplicate this, and let me rename this to text. I'm just gonna call it display text 1. Let's see, let's open it. This is going to be a blank script. We're going to start from zero. Wow. So let's apply this blank script to this lady. Let's apply changes. And let's test it out. I just want to show you that if you come close to her now, nothing happens. You just bump noses. She's not bad looking, except for those pants. I don't know about those pants. So let's open our script again. I'm using Notepad Plus, which is a free program you can get online. I will leave a link down in the description below. So let's call this Sparkman Display. RPG stuff, blah blah blah, and let's make a function. It's gonna be a function display text init for initialization. Make sure you put the E there, and let's end the function. Now this happens only once in the game, okay, so it's good for declaring variables and stuff like that. Actually, it has to be text 1 because it has to be the name of the file. So let me just copy this, and I'm going to paste it down below. Let's change this to main, because this is always going to be running. So under main, let's display some text. It's gonna be text color and 000, three zeros. Okay, so this is X and Y. The last zero is your text size, which is going to be 1. So let's type something. It's going to be hello world and three zeros. This is RGB. Red, green, and blue. So let's make this a red, 255. Values only get up to 255. So let's run this to see what this looks like. Where is my text? On the Y coordinate, we're gonna set this at 250. And yeah, let me try it out. You can see the text there on the left. Okay, so let me set that to 20 and maybe this to 10. That looks better. Yeah, so let's make a variable for the player distance. Player distance. Okay, player distance. Wow. And don't forget your E. So that's just a variable to get the player distance. So if player distance, say less than 100, then we're going to display our text. So now this text is only going to display if we get close to her. Let's get close to her. There we go. Hello world. And yeah, you get the idea. Let me make one of those RPG panels. Zero is 4 zeros because it's a box. 2 zeros are for the position. That's the X position and the Y position. Now for the size, let's make this at 20. 20. It's basically going to be a box. There is our box. Oh, it's almost there. Let me try 10, 8, 20, 40. Let me play around with those numbers. Let's see if I get a better position. And 245 of green. Let's see what we get. It's sort of orangey color. I'm going to cut this panel and place it before our text. So the panel is going to show behind the text. position of the text 1514. See what that looks like. Walk up to the lady. And that's a lot better. So at the beginning of the level, this only happens once. Let's make a variable. And we're gonna call this show text equals 0. Okay, so we can make it so this panel only shows up if show text is equal 0. So if show text equals 0, then we show the panel in the text. Let's end the statement. Let me make another variable. I'm gonna call this a delay equals 0. Let me enter a comment here so I know this is where distance starts. And this is where distance ends. Okay, so if the user presses the E button and delay is equal to 0, then we're gonna show show text equals show text plus 1. This will increase show text by 1. Let's end this. I'm gonna copy this text. Which is the position to 30. And instead of hello world, we can display show text. Okay, let's try it out. Walk up to her. Now you can see that show text shows up there at the 0. Now if I press E, this is going to increase it by 1. Or not. What did we do wrong? Okay, I forgot the uppercase. Let's try this again. Walk up to the lady. And let's press E. You can see that the number increases. So if I hold the button, this will keep going up. And that's why we made the variable for the delay. So we're going to increase also delay. It's going to be delay equals delay plus 1. Try it out. Let's press the button. That works fine. So if delay is greater than 100, then... So if delay reaches 100, we're going to set it to 0. In that statement, I'm going to copy this, paste it. So if delay is greater than 0, then we're going to keep adding 1 to it. Delay equals delay plus 1. Okay, looks like I misspelled that delay. Just fix it. Delay, not delay. I don't think delay is a word. let me try this out. There we go. Press I'm gonna press E. And it goes to 1, 2, 3. So now we can display text based on that counter. Let me just copy this text here. I'm going to paste it here. So show text equals 1 is going to display take this sword. You will need it. Okay, let me just copy that again. Paste it. This is going to be show text equals 2. And then we're going to type this is an RPG text example. Let's run this. Let's press E to change the text. And that works fine. Now, if you walk away from her and you come back, you can see that our number is still 3. Okay, so we need to reset that. So after distance in, player distance is greater than 100. Then we're gonna set that delay back to 0 and show text back to 0. Let's end this. Let's try it out. Press E to change the text. Now set to 3. Let's walk away. And let's come back. And our text returns. Walk away. And the text keeps coming back. Which is what we want. Wow. I'm going to make the counter invisible. I'm simply going to comment. Show text. Okay, wait a second. When we show up from the side... Well, she doesn't turn around. You can set this to rotate to player. Put the E there. Let's walk up from the side now. And she turns around. It's kind of creepy how she turns so fast, but it's better than if she doesn't turn. We can do a more smooth turning in the next video. Alright guys, that's it. That's how you can make RPG text boxes for your games. If you got any questions, comment down below. Actually, comment down below anyways. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. Okay guys, see you in the next video. Bye now.